blown away in some other towns.
We're not going to find out for
unfortunately, yeah.
A few weeks.
Yeah, but
I'm sorry. So I just think, why can't it wait till June? My guess is some of this stuff is going to be facing us pretty quickly, long before June. And rather than depleting the, unless we call for another special in June if we use the reserve fund, and again, that's up to the finance committee, it's out of our hands. Again, they're generally rather conservative as far as expending the funds from those, that source. We could do something in June.
I would prefer then, if we're going to do that, is to take some sizable portion of this amount of money and put it in the reserve fund. Add it to the reserve fund, let the finance committee deal with it.
Good.
Then if
it's a mechanism that it's available, right.
Greg.
My suggestion again is we do have a warrant article. Article number 20 deals with capital expenditures.
Mm-hmm.
We did not provide specific items in the warrants, so we certainly do have some flexibility to reassess what our costs are and transfer monies under those articles for the purposes of road improvements or facility improvements. I'm just not comfortable bringing a number to town meeting when someone says, what's the basis of your justification? I'm going to say it's a 10,000 foot view, not a specific number that I've really had time, and I just don't have time to put that number together for town meeting in a couple of days.
Yeah, I'm not overly, and I understand your concern, Greg. I don't want to leave you open to unnecessary criticism. But I'd be more than happy to share some of the responsibilities with you on that, because I think there isn't anybody out there that doesn't expect that there's going to be some extraordinary costs that we weren't accounting on in relation to the impact of the storm. And I like the idea of at least having some additional revenue available in the short order, so we don't have to wait until June to do it. And if it, the mechanism, as the chairman suggested, of putting in the reserve fund allows us to do that.
You say you have some anticipated costs, and we're putting money in the reserve fund to cover it.
Yep.
So if you can identify,
it's not being just allocated.
Yeah. So if you can identify, if you're not wiping out the surplus in these other accounts, and we have some additional revenues that we can allocate to the reserve fund for the specific purpose of addressing storm damage.
Okay.
I think that would be another item under this.
Makes sense.
That makes sense to me.
Okay.
All right. So who's going to
whatever you come up with?
Who's going to do moving right along? Who's going to do Article 1?
If you want, I'll do it. That's fine.
You're going to have to get together with him and finalize the numbers, okay?
Yep,
I'm ready. Steve's doing number one. Article 2, prior year's bills. Volunteer?
I'll do it.
Joe. We don't have much here, do we, Greg, as I recall?
We have one medical bill for a retired public safety employee, $695.
And nothing else has come up?
No.
What was it?
$695. And Article 3 of the special town meeting.
This one?
What?
Who's doing $695?
I am. John.
Joe.
Joe.
And then Article 23, fund retirement obligations. How much is that now, Greg?
It's $75,000.
And that's to cover the,
we had three unanticipated retirements that we had to pay the buybacks on, and those were not foreseen when we went to town meeting last year.
I'll take it.
And I can get you the detail on
this general government and school?
In the case...
No, these actually are all general government retirements.
General government?
Yes. In the case of death, we have obligations too?
Not in that instance, no.
No?
No.
Okay. All right, so
I'll take it.
Sean's going to take it? Okay. So be sure to get all the detail from Greg.
Yeah.
Okay. Regular town meeting. We're going to go through up to Article 19, I think. No, 19 is the operating budget. We're going to do through 18, right? That's the intent?
That's right.
Right.
Okay, so Selection of town offices, and here are reports of town committees. I'll do that. Do the easy ones.
Do both?
What?
Start off with a win.
What?
Start off with a win.
Yeah.
I'll do number two.
Easements. Jeff. And are we gonna do all the, let's see, we got the.
Who's doing two? I'm sorry, Jeff?
Three.
Bob was doing one and two.
Bob's doing one and two.
Oh, you're doing one and two, okay.
Jeff's doing three.
Jeff's doing three. Authorized treasurer, authorized chapter 90, rescind bond authorizations. Who wants to do, well, we'll just do one, each one individually.
I'll do four.
Joe? Five.
I'll do five.
Jeff? Six, rescind bond authorizations. This is a cash neutral issue, right?
It is, it relates to some bonding authorization that we have for the Batchelder School.
So this is money they haven't spent and it was never borrowed?
That's right.
I'll take it.
Sean? And fund the town share of 62 culvert. This one is gonna take, is Dick gonna put a presentation together or something that I need to do?
No, he's putting together a presentation.
All right, so, Steve?
Yep.
It's gonna be a very fast presentation, I bet. Dick, he's so quick.
Well, I mean, I think they gotta put some information up as to why it has to be done.
Photos from the last two storms?
Yeah, I hope he's out there taking pictures. Fund the stormwater infiltration project, that's.
Janet.
What?
Janet and Dick.
Janet?
Yeah.
So who's gonna read the motion? I'll read it. And I guess I'll talk to her and find out what she's gonna present. Conservation revolving fund, these are all the reauthorizations, we wanna do them all at once?
That's the initial motion that'll be put forth is for Articles 9 through 17 to be voted, and that's how it was done in the past.
9 through 17 will be, why don't I do it? If it gets split, we'll.
Divvy it up later.
Divvy it up. And then energy conservation rebates revolving fund.
That would be me.
That'll be Jeff.
Which number was that anyway, was that?
18.
18?
Mr. Chairman.
Who's doing 18?
I'm sorry.
Jeff?
Yes.
We have an issue, right?
We do, yeah, we do. You're aware of the issue concerning the fact that the Department of Revenue won't let us do this?
No, that I wasn't aware of.
All right, well, the Finance Director did check with the Department of Revenue concerning the establishment of a revolving fund to receive energy conservation rebates. And according to the Department of Revenue, the rebates and credits would not be used to establish a revolving fund. The method that the DOR would approve is to capture these monies and then have those monies be credited to the general fund and close out to free cash. Therefore, the town could appropriate it as certified free cash in a future town meeting, so they will not allow.
So we're gonna pass over this. Jeff, you still can do it.
Will we be able to do something by October? No, free cash isn't generally certified by October.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it will be.
It will be.
Yes, it will be.
Yeah. The issue, though, is again, is the risk factor associated with what happens with free cash at the end of the year.
Yeah.
Right.
We don't have, you know, without, well, it's something we should sit down with the collector on.
What do we have for rebate monies that could be gonna be coming available in short order? Is there a?
Thought it was somewhere in the range of $17,000.
Now, they said that we could take it off a bill. Would DOR allow that?
Well, you could take it off the bill, but then you don't see it.
You don't see it.
When it comes off a bill, it doesn't go into free cash, it could get lost that way. Right?
Yeah, and if we establish the revolving fund with available funds from building, maintenance, or energy, we do the offset. Take $17,000 off of building energy costs, transfer it in here to establish it and get the seed money going. And then when it comes in, well, actually, we won't expend it, take it off the bill.
Come off the bill?
Mm-hmm.
I suspect DOR won't allow that either, but I think it's worth a question, maybe.
Oh, no, it's just a question of appropriation. We can transfer money from any line item we want.
No, no, I mean.
Establish a fund.
The problem is what they're saying, it's not available cash until after it's certified.
Right.
Until it's certified, right, so what we're saying is, I think it's important to get this thing going and get it established, and whatever mechanism we determine internally to handle it, whether it be.
Well.
Crediting that account with anticipated funds, with non-expenditure.
Is it not that we can have a revolving fund for it, but we can't put the money directly into it, is that what you're saying?
You can't.
That's it.
What was that?
Can't put the rebate.
Put the rebate money into it. You can set up a fund, but that can't be the mechanism.
So within the four corners of this article, could it be read in such a way that?
Says specifically.
We could just set up the account.
Revolving account.
And then we can figure out how to.
Well, then you'd have to take and be committed to take whatever rebates came in each October or whatever and transfer them into the revolving. Can't do that.
No.
No, it says rebates.
We can't transfer it to the revolving.
No, they say what the opinion from DOR says is you have to vote free cash specifically for the purpose.
No, that's what I'm saying, is you vote, in other words, you just keep track of what came in, and then at an appropriate time, when you have free cash, you put it into the revolving fund. Or you can't do that.
I don't think you want to do that. I think it's easier just to vote the free cash out for whatever purpose you wish for energy conservation projects.
All right, so we're going to pass this over. Is your recommendation?
Is it worth asking DOR if we want to use the rebates to reduce a utility bill?
I'll touch base with the finance director. He was the one that passed the information on to me.
I don't know if the article will allow us to do that.
No, I know the article may not, but.
Well, I mean, it may be something we have to deal with in October.
Right, but yeah, I would set up some sort of mechanism for October to to identify whatever the savings are, identify them, and force us to put it into this account.
But we can't just set up a revolving fund right now.
No, I think what Greg is saying, you don't need a revolving fund. If it has to go into free cash, you just apply that to the project. You apply a certain amount of money in an article to the project.
But what DOR suggests is if you want to set up an account, you want to call it an energy conservation stabilization account. So that would be the final repository for any of these monies that get approved into free cash.
But rather than what's being suggested here, energy conservation rebate revolving account, don't identify it as a rebate, because that limits. I mean, we can set up an energy conservation revolving account, as suggested, but leave the rebates out of it. We can set up the revolving account for specified projects, and then in our own mind and in our own county here, apply those rebates.
So you think we can reword an article that fits within the four corners of this article?
I think your problem is the fact that it has rebates in it. I think that's the problem.
But you can diminish that. I think that's okay.
I don't know. that is really a change. I think. Well,
The notice of this here is to establish this energy conservation revolving account. We're identifying a source as the rebates. There could be other sources, though, too, that we may want to allocate funds from.
Yeah, well, we that was one of the conversations that we had. We had the RMLD as the sole source of the
which would mean there wouldn't
funds,
be any,
which means we couldn't get it from any place else, and that was, we wanted to address that issue as well. But if you make it just an energy conservation revolving account, meaning the funds can come from more than one place, then that fits the four corners.
Could I forward you a copy of the DOR advisory, and then it'll give you an opportunity to see what they consider allowable and not allowable? I don't have it in front of me. I didn't print it off.
I would say if we can just